Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the pitch of pressure, not the resolution, the pitch. Well, it's part of resolution, right? So the pitch of pressure. So let's look at a definition. Pitch is the quality of sound governed by the rate of vibrations producing it. So it's quantifiable. It's empirical. It's a number. Okay, let's look at the numbers. 100 hertz means 100 vibrations per second. Quantifiable. We can measure and see. If it's maybe 90, it's low pitch. If it's 110, maybe it's high pitch if we're using 100 as our reference. So the bottom line here is it's digital. It's kind of a digital kindness, if you will, because you can measure it and you can measure variances, and that is good. You know, that helps us. So we got quantifiable and qualifiable. The qualifiable is more subjective in nature, and we'll talk about that when it comes to tone, because that's more qualifiable. So I think you understand that. All musical sound is produced with pitch management today. If you just want to understand that, just watch some 80s and 90s live recordings. You'll see that, you know, they didn't really concern themselves with pitch that much. Well, they didn't have the ability in post, I think, to manage it. They do today in the digital domain. So you want to have your room resolution to be great enough that you can hear pitch variances. That's the fun part, to hear the differences and the changes. And there's a lot of emotion in a singer's voice that can control all of that and stay on pitch. There's a great harmony that goes on through all frequency ranges. So low frequency has to be only heard in a room that's very high resolution. It's hard to get pitch out of a room where you have so many room modes and reverb times are high. You want to get all of that balance. Our CAW, our in-wall low frequency management system with our carbon, is very good at that, because every 14 and a half inches, the distance between a stud, we manage that frequency and amplitude of problem in that room location. And if that particular room location has a 40 cycle problem that's plus 12 and the rest of the room is plus 9, then we got to add some more carbon to get that 3 dB. We have that kind of control over rate. That's why we can guarantee the performance of our rooms. Nobody else can do that. Well, we can. We have the technology. That's why they don't. If they could, they would. Trust me. So you got to have a pressure balanced room. The CAW does that. The pressure balancing removes a layer of distortion, because I'm sure you've heard this, where you say, well, move this around, try to get out of the room modes. Well, room modes are every 36 inches in a room. How are you going to dodge that bullet? You're not. So that's another kind of nonsense that we hear all the time that makes no sense. So you got to have a balanced room that sounds the same in every location of the room. That's got to be the goal. And the CAW does that. We've even treated the floor, ceiling, and the four walls, the whole room in some projects. Just simply frame out the floor like you would the four walls and ceiling. Install the combination of 10s and 12s, because the 12 is 30 to 50 strong, and the 10 is 30 to 300 strong. So you need a combination of those two frequency ranges for low frequency management in the room. And get your subwoofers out of the corner. If your goal is high resolution, sticking subs in the corner means you have to change the strategy of your room goal, because that's not a tactic you want to use in a high resolution room. You'll destroy the pitch, and we're going to talk about in the next video, you're going to destroy the tone. So you don't want any part of that. So, pitch of pressure. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.